दिस इज वन ऑफ द कैलकुलेशन इंटेंसिव सेट्स इन दिस मॉक ऑफ द सेकेंड सेक्शंस. सो दिस सेट शुड बी अटेम्प्टेड आफ्टर अटेम्प्टिंग द ईजियर सेट्स ऑफ दिस सेक्शन एज इट वुड टेक सम टाइम बट इट इज़ नॉट अ डिफिकल्ट सेट एज सच बिकॉज हेयर नॉट मच लॉजिक इज इन्वॉल्व. देर इज़ अ प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ अ मल्टी नेशनल कंपनी हाउसेज सेवन टाइपिस्ट. ऑल ऑफ देम आर वर्किंग ऑन अ प्रोजेक्ट. द गिवन डायग्राम डिपिक्स देयर परफॉर्मेंस ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ 4 days. इन ईच डायग्राम द फोर कॉर्नर फिगर्स शो द परसेंटेज ऑफ टोटल लाइन्स टाइप्ड ऑन दैट डे बाय द टॉप 4 टाइपिस्ट ऑफ द डे वेयर एज मिडिल सर्कल डिनोट्स द टोटल नंबर ऑफ लाइन्स टाइप्ड बाय द रिमेनिंग 3 टाइपिस्ट पुट टुगेदर ऑन दैट डे. सो लेट्स हैव अ लुक एट फिगर. When we see at first figure or diagram, then we see 4 corner figures. These are giving the lines, the percentage of lines out of the total typed by the top 4 typists, which means the typist who typed the maximum number of lines on day first typed 24% of the total lines, and the second typed 23%, third 20%, and fourth 14%. It means out of the remaining 3 typists, no one would have typed 14% or more number of lines out of the total. And middle circle gives the total number of lines typed by the remaining 3 or bottom 3 typists. And on adding the 4 corner figures, we get the sum as 81%, which means top 4 typists typed 81%. And the remaining 19% lines were typed by the bottom 3 typists, and it is 76. On the basis of this, we can find the total number of lines typed on the day first, which comes out to be 400. Similarly, we can see this thing for the remaining 3 figures. Now, coming back to the given info, and it is also given that no 2 typists typed the same number of lines on any of the given 4 days, which means if a particular typist typed X number of lines on a particular day, no other typist typed this many lines on that day. A typist may type even a single line, on a given day, which means a typist could have typed even 0 line on a particular day out of the given 4. HR also computed 2 parameters for each typist, and these parameters are: performance variance is the positive difference between the sum of the maximum and minimum number of lines typed by a typist over a period of 4 days, and the sum of lines typed on the remaining 2 days, which means if X, Y, Z and W are the lines typed by a particular typist on a day such that X is more than Y and this is more than Z and Z is more than W, then PV is defined as the absolute difference of the sum of X and Z, these are maximum and minimum values, and of lines typed, plus or minus the sum of Y and Z, number of lines typed by the typist on the remaining 2 days. And the second parameter is sigma is the mean of the 2 middle quantities when a typist number of lines typed across 4 days is arranged in non decreasing order, which means basically it is average of Y and Z. So that's all about the info given here. Now we can find the number of lines typed by the 4 typists on each of the 4 given days, as well as the range of number of lines typed by the bottom 3 typists. Now coming to the day first, as we have already computed the total number of line typed on day first as 400, and we know the percentage of line typed by Gaurav, which is 23%, So from here we get the number of lines typed by Goro on day 1st as 92. Similarly, we can find the number of lines typed by Salim, Sanjay and Amar on the basis of percentage of lines typed by them. Now coming to the remaining three guys, as it is known that these three guys typed the number of lines which was less than the number of line typed by the people who are given in the figure, which means each of these three persons must have typed less than 55 lines. This is the least out of the four given figures in the for the day first. Therefore, the number of lines that Kapil could have typed or must have typed on day first would have ranged between 0 and 55. Same will go for Deepak and Kandar. Similarly, we can find these figures for day second and day third as well as day four. There is an interesting thing that we need to note here about day 3. After the top 4 typist lines are considered, we come to know that the minimum number of lines typed by the typist who typed the 4th maximum number of lines is 42, and the total number of lines typed by the remaining or the bottom 3 typist comes out to be, as it is given in the table, as 105. So if two typists type the maximum possible number of lines, this would be 41, as 42 is the threshold below which this figure should come. Lines typed by the two typists would go to 82. Still we are left with 24 lines. Would not go 82 because no two typists type the same number of lines. If the number of lines for two typists is maximized, then it would be 40 and 41, and this sum will be 81. So the remaining difference would still be 24, which means no typist on day 3 type less than 24 lines. If it were the case, then given condition would not be valid. So on day 3, the minimum number of lines typed by each of the three bottom typists must have been 24, and this figure or the maximum could go to 41. Now coming to the value of sigma, again we cannot find unique value of sigma for the given 7 typists, as we do not have their all exact values of number of lines typed on all the 4 days. So we can find range, and here we are interested in minimum and maximum values of sigma. If we want to minimize the value of sigma, then we have to minimize the middle figures or the number of lines typed which are neither maximum nor minimum. If we look at the case of Gaurav, then on the basis of the given info that we have in this table, we can say that 48 should be one of the two middle values, and we have to minimize the value of sigma, then other value has to be the minimum, and it can be 0, as on day 2nd he could have typed the number of line falling anywhere between 0 and 55, and on day 4 again between 0 and 44. So the minimum number of lines that Goro could have typed on day 2 and day 4 could have been 0. So the minimum value of sigma for him will be 0 plus 48 by 2, this is 24, एंड इन ऑर्डर टू मैक्सिमाइज द वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा वील हैव टू मैक्सिमाइज द सेकेंड और अननोन मिडिल वैल्यू फॉर द पर्सन. हेयर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट गौरव. द मिनिमम नंबर ऑफ सॉरी मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ लाइन दैट ही कुड हैव टाइप व्हेन वी कंसिडर द मिडिल फिगर्स इट कुड नॉट बी मोर देन 55. दैट इज ऑन डे टू. सो द मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा फॉर गौरव विल बी 55 प्लस 48 अपॉन टू दैट इज 51.5. सिमिलरली वी कैन कंप्यूट द वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा फॉर द रिमेनिंग सिक्स पर्सन्स. सो दैट्स ऑल अबाउट सिग्मा एंड ऑल. नाउ कमिंग टू द क्वेश्चन. इन द फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इट इज गिवन दैट द सिग्मा फॉर ऑल टाइप इज एन इंटीजर. फॉर हाउ मेनी ऑफ देम इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू कैलकुलेट द एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ इट. इफ वी लुक एट द केस ऑफ गौरव मिनिमम वैल्यू इज 24, मैक्सिमम इज 51.5. सो देर आर वेरियस इंटीजर्स बिटवीन दीज टू फिगर्स. सो इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल फॉर अस टू फाइंड द एग्जैक्ट वैल्यू ऑफ सिग्मा फॉर गौरव. सिमिलरली वी कैन सी द केस ऑफ सलीम. हेयर वी हैव 49 एंड 50 एंड बोथ आर इंटीजर एंड देर इज नो अदर इंटीजर बिटवीन दीज टू इंटीजर. सो देर आर टू पॉसिबल वैल्यूज ऑफ सिग्मा फॉर सलीम. बट वेन वी लुक एट द केस ऑफ संजय देन वी फाइंड these two figures that is minimum and maximum values of sigma are 75 and 75.5. there is only one integral value between 75 and 75.5 including both and that is 75. so for Sanjay it is possible to find exact value of sigma. and similarly if we proceed for the other persons we come to know that it is not possible for them to find the exact value of sigma. so there is only one person for whom we can find the exact value of sigma and for the rest of persons we cannot find the exact value of sigma. so there are six persons for whom we can't find the exact value of sigma. hence the option D has to be the correct answer as it says more than four. coming to the next problem. For which of the given types can the value of PV be 0? Now this is a bit tricky question. Here we need to check or we need to look at the maximum and minimum as well as two middle values for each of the four persons. As we have taken x and w as minimum and maximum respectively and y and z as two middle values and we have to check the possibilities whether it is possible for some of the people that the value of x plus w minus y plus z be zero or not. And on careful observation, we find that there are only two guys, and these are Salim and Sanjay, for whom it is possible by taking value. In fact, the number of lines typed by Salim on day first is 56, on day second, it is 70. Fine. Similarly, we can find the number of line typed by Sanjay on day first as 96 and on day third as 54 and on day four as 99. And if we look at the second day, the number of lines that Sanjay could have typed ranges between 0 and 55. फ्रॉम हेयर इफ वी टेक हिज वैल्यू ऑन डे टू एज 51, देन वी रियलाइज दैट सम ऑफ 51 एंड 99 इज इक्वल टू द सम ऑफ 96 एंड 54 एज दीज टू आर मिडिल वैल्यूज. सिमिलरली वी कैन सी दिस थिंग फॉर सलीम एज वेल. इट इज ऑल्सो नोन टू अस दैट द नंबर ऑफ लाइन टाइप बाय सलीम ऑन डे 3rd इज 42. एंड इफ वी टेक अ फिगर ऑफ 28 ऑन डे 4, वी वुड सी 70 प्लस 28 इज इक्वल टू 56. Plus 42, and on checking in the similar fashion for other guys, we would not see this scenario or situation. Therefore, option C is the correct answer. However, it should be noted here it is a bit difficult question, because if we check cases for all the seven guys, then it would be very difficult and time consuming in examination scenario to sort this out. So we can leave out or leave aside this kind of question while writing exam, unless until we have ample time to handle such thing. And moreover, one more thing could be seen here for only two people, that is, and these are Salim and Sanjay, for whom we know the number of lines typed on three days out of the 4 days. So it was possible for them to compute this, but this could not be, this is not the case for the other guys. Now that's all about this question. Come to the next question. During the event period, how many typists did definitely type more number of pages than what Kapil did? If we want to find the minimum number of minimum number of typists who definitely type more number of pages than Kapil, then we need to maximize the number of lines that Kapil could have typed on those 4 days, and this comes out to be 55, as he could not have typed more than 55 lines on the day first. On day 2nd, he typed 56 line. On day 3, he typed 51 line. And on day 4, he could have typed 44 at number of line at max. So this comes out to be 206. Therefore, Kapil could not have typed more than 206 lines. And if we look at the table carefully, we see that Sanjay and Deepak would definitely have typed more number of lines than 206, as the figure that are known for these two persons when added crosses 206. So these two are the guys who must have definitely typed more number of pages than what Kapil did. Therefore, option B is the correct answer. Now coming to the last question. Here it is asking for which typist was the absolute difference between max minimum and maximum possible value of sigma the least. As we have already computed, it is the case for Sanjay. His minimum value of sigma is 75 and maximum value is 75.5. Therefore, A is the correct answer. That's all about